Gary Schleifer is the chief sustainability professional at C.H. Guernsey & Company, an Oklahoma-based architecture and engineering firm. He has a background in underwater filmmaking, and he's a psychologist, which is why he's now in an architecture firm. I mean, that underwater basket weaving, psychology, that all kind of goes together. Gary's unique perspective is how to approach the creation of new sustainable built environments and the transformation of existing ones. His passion and unique background, combined with his 18 years of experience immersed in the green building movement in a very, very intimate way, and his intimacy with these strategies and practices, along with his understanding of the LEED building rating system, give him the perfect skill set to facilitate the process of creating high-performance environments. Mr. Schleifer is engaged in ongoing Department of Defense, commercial, residential, and school projects pursuing LEED certification. Would you please help me in welcoming Gary Schleifer?
I am honored to be here in front of all of you extremely smart people. I cannot tell you how passionate I am to have this stance in front of you, in front of the pioneers of what our building industry will look like in the future. Because the people in this room will help shape the way we design, we look at our built environments. And through the seminars that I was, or the speakers that were ahead of me, I understand that buildings and products are very analogous. They all have the similar components that all go together in making a system. Ken mentioned my background. Yes, a very diverse background. What is an underwater cameraman doing here talking to you? Well, I have been doing numerous projects underwater, and I was witnessing firsthand the destruction of our planet. I have been going to reefs for years and years, and as I returned to them on some occasions from one year to the next, the year before vibrant with life, the year after almost desolate, like a desert. It brought tears to my eyes. If you could cry underwater, I was. So through my career as an underwater cameraman is what brought me here. I knew I had to do something. I didn't know what exactly it was until it fell into my lap. When a group of my friends said, let's build a sustainable community. And of course I said, what's that? Through a five-year process, I and a group of my friends at the time went through the entire process of understanding what sustainability was from an owner-occupant standpoint. That launched my grassroots participation in the green building movement, and 10 years later, I made it my profession. And in that process, I have my master's in marriage and family therapy, which I usually call, I'm a psychologist, because people don't understand what a marriage and family therapist is. Well, I was and still am an agent of change. I help people understand themselves and the relationships they're in to better understand how to have solutions, how to come up with solutions, and how to have a happier life. Analogous to green building, as I discovered. All of these things, all of the experiences from my life, my careers, led me to become an expert in sustainable design. I put them all together and understand very clearly that our biggest challenge is not the technology, is not the overwhelming problems. It's the aspect of change, of that paradigm shift that so many speakers before me have mentioned. And how do we create this paradigm shift? How do we go from a poorly designed, poorly built, poorly operated and maintained built environment to one that makes sense? Because it doesn't make sense now, because there is only one bottom line. And previous speakers mentioned, the triple bottom line. I'm going to phrase it a little bit differently. The bottom line is the triple bottom line, and I will get into that in a moment. But in order to understand these challenges is to understand the systems in which we operate and we affect. And the term that many of you may have heard of or not is cybernetics. Cybernetics is essentially the study of systems. And by understanding these systems, their interrelationship and their relationships, we can better come up with solutions. It is cross-platform, if you will. It is from one discipline to the next. It is the interconnection. It is the interrelationship between our understandings of the systems we work in and work around us. And these systems are the physical world, the emotional world, the behavioral world, the social world, and that interconnectedness. And this is what I believe that we need to embrace, the understanding of how these systems play upon each other and affect each other to enable us to see things differently and to push forward this paradigm shift that we need to embrace. There are a plethora of systems that we are constantly engaged in and happen around us that we're unaware of, that once we look at it from a cybernetic perspective, may have a different perspective on how to approach these things. Now, these are just a series of images that I've gathered to talk about the systems. Now, what most people see is the boat, the plane, the object. But what we often forget about, not probably in this room, but our world, is that they operate within another set of systems. The water, the air, gravity, space, time. And I refer to our natural systems because for some reason, and this is what we all strive for, and this is what I, without having a lot of knowledge in biomimicry, is when I heard that term for the first time, I go, that's it. If we're able to mimic what nature does, then I think we might be able to save ourselves. Because the way we're going right now, I don't have a lot of hope. I don't want to talk doom and gloom because no one likes to hear doom and gloom. But we talk about carbon footprint, we talk about climate change, we talk about all of these things that we can't tangibly get our hands and our minds really wrapped around. We're told our climate is changing it because of us. We're told we don't, until something dramatic happens, we will not make the timeline. Not in our generation, maybe not in our kids, but perhaps our grandkids are going to see it. We may see it in our generation as well. We don't know. The concept of circular causality, which is a cybernetic systems concept of change. Change is an essential component, and the understanding of the essential component of change in everything we do is an important component to understand and to embrace, because what has led us here is our fear of change. One of the things that has led us here, our fear of change. And this fear of change has made us so afraid of the risk that we have to take. And the people in this room are in places that can create these changes. This is something I drew out of my head. There is no way to graphically represent a system working within systems in the context of sustainability. This is my global view, a portion of it, of the quantity of systems and the effects upon each other that are at play when we go about trying to create a more sustainable cell phone or home. And LEED certification, which is my specialty, is imperfect, but all things are imperfect. LEED is an excellent roadmap for built environments to achieve higher levels of sustainability. This is my little system map of LEED certification. LEED is a portion of the broad spectrum of the way we look at sustainability. And it's my belief that if we